Okay, so I just wanted to come on here really quick and talk about the Feast of St. Lucy's Day. So this is kind of a big deal in the Catholic faith for a lot of different families throughout the world. And so I wanted to talk a little bit about it just in case you haven't heard of it. If you have and you and your family do this tradition, please in the comments write what you guys do. Share your ideas so that people can really get into these traditions and stuff with their family, because it is important to teach our families about the Catholic faith. And even though the Catholic faith, we do a lot of fasting and penance, we also do a lot of feasting and joyful things as well. So we want to kind of balance it out, because there is a lot of both of those within the Catholic faith. So if you are new here, definitely subscribe down below and hit the little bell button. My name is Heather. I'm a Catholic mommy YouTuber, and I love talking about the Catholic faith and about mommy life and just everything in between. And so anyway, let me get into it. So St. Lucy's feast day is December 13th. Okay, so traditionally what you do on St. Lucy's feast day is you have your oldest girl wear a white gown. And the reason she wears a white gown is it signifies purity. So St. Lucy died a virgin, and she was pure when she died. And she has a red sash because the red represents that she was a martyr and she died out of love for God. And there's a wreath on her head, which means eternal, never ending. God's love is never ending. And then there's candles on her head because her name represents light. And there's also a story that goes with it. So I'm going to share with you the story that goes with it towards the end. So traditionally, St. Lucy is all dressed up. So a little girl dressed up in that outfit. And then she brings sweet rolls or a sweet bread or donut, something sweet to her family. And so in our family, we have these. These are just like those canned cinnamon rolls. And so we'll make these on St. Lucy's feast day. And all the kids love it because we don't have these very often. These are really yummy. But you, like I said, you can use donuts or whatever you want. Something sweet for your family. And then I read them this story. And this is Lucia, Saint of Light. And this is great because it actually tells the story of, you know, the tradition. So it's a family celebrating St. Lucy's feast day and what they do in Sweden. And then it also tells St. Lucy like about her life and how she died and why she died. And also, this is what I was always wondering, was why is it celebrated so highly in Sweden, even though St. Lucy is actually from Italy? So this does an awesome job explaining that. And let me just briefly explain why. So first, let me talk a little bit about St. Lucy and her life. So she was actually born in Italy, and then she was supposed to, you know, be married to this man, and God asked her to remain a virgin, to be pure her whole life. And so she told this man she couldn't marry him. He got really upset and pretty much had tortured her, and she ended up dying. So that is why we wear the white, because she was pure, and she has the red because she was a martyr around the waist. So you might be wondering, so how does that relate to Sweden? So what happened was, in the Middle Ages, there was a great famine throughout Sweden, and they all decided to pray to St. Lucy. And when they did that, a miracle happened. And during the dark time, the night time, a huge ship was coming in, and on that ship was bright light. When the ship finally like got to them, it was St. Lucy, and she was just all bright white, and on the ship was bread. So it fed the people, and that is why you actually have your different sweets in the morning, because that represents the miracle that happened in Sweden and saved so many people from dying. So that is the sweet little story. I mean, this actually goes into it a lot more, but that is kind of in general what happened. So there's also some other really cute little things that people do. Like, a lot of people will get in the car, and since it's around, you know, Christmas time, a lot of lights out on people's lawns. So I've heard of people going and getting hot chocolate and then driving around and seeing all the Christmas lights on the Feast of St. Lucy. And her name actually means light. So that kind of makes sense. And I just thought that was like a really fun tradition. It's so great to talk about our Catholic faith and all these little feast days to help our children to grow closer to God. Because when you learn about the saints, it can do nothing but help you to grow in virtue and goodness. That is why I believe that God gave us the saints, was to pray for us, to help us, but also to be that living example. And through sharing their life with us, we get to grow too, and we get to see what holiness looks like within other people. So I think these feast days are really important and so sweet. I hope that you guys will celebrate this feast day with your children. Make it happy and fun and joyful, because it is a joyous occasion to celebrate these saints. So anyway, I hope that y'all are having a great Advent, and until next time, I will see you all later. God bless. Bye.